Hello guys, welcome back with me. Ciao ciao 2025. SadTalker is a free AI tools that can make a picture of face move and talk using any audio file that contain voice. It also gave a little movement on the head, but you can also set this if the head move unrealistic. The first thing you do before this is to have Python 3.8, fmpeg and git. In this example, I use Conda, but it is optional. Conda used to make a new environment since I already have many applications that use other Python version. You could use Anaconda or Miniconda. Both is free for personal use. It just a simply download and install, so I will not show it here. Tutorial of how to install Python, Git, and ffmpeg is in video description. First, I create an environment using Conda for Python 3.8. Then I activate the environment. Next is to access your installation directory. I suggest to put it on the up level of the environment directory. Write git clone like in video description and press enter. Wait until it's finished downloading. At this point, I copy ffmpeg bin file and paste it on the Python in my environment. If you don't use Conda and you already install ffmpeg, you don't need to do this. But if you found error that has something to do with ffmpeg, you might want to copy the bin file to your python.x directory. The next thing to do is to download the model. Check the GitHub page for link to the model. Download it and save into your SadTalker installation directory /checkpoint. You need to create the checkpoint folder yourself. Remember to extract the model if what you download is compressed into zip or rare. You could also download GFGAN model to repair the face. Although it is optional, I still suggest you to download this. Without GFGAN, the face will appear really bad and broken. Link for the GFGAN model also on the SadTalker GitHub page. Download the model and put it on SadTalker installation directory /GFGAN. Now you could close the Conda. To open the SadTalker, you need to double-click the web ie.bat in SadTalker directory. If this is your first time, open it. It will download and install some new library. If you run it and met with error message, attribute error, row object has no attribute style. The solution is first you need to access the venv of SadTalker. From SadTalker directory, just write venv /script/activate.bat. Now, from there, uninstall gradio by writing pip uninstall gradio. After the uninstall process finished, write pip install gradio =3.41.2. After the installation finished, just close the command prompt. Open the web ui.bat again. SadTalker will now be able to run. To use this is as simple as put a picture and a voice file and then click generate. There are two face model resolution, 256 and 512. Select according to your source image resolution. Using other resolution could also work, but make sure you choose full or extfull in the pre-process. The pre-process is how to handle the input image. Crop will crop the image into the resolution that you choose. It will crop the image and will try to focus on the face. Resize will resize the picture into the resolution that you choose. Full will not reduce the picture size and use the original resolution. Xcrop will give you similar result to crop but with extend movement. Extol will give you similar result to full but with extend movement. This is an example of how to use it. I use voice from my other video. This is the voice file.
Now to use it, we're going to make a prompt first. You could use any prompt to generate a woman, including her body. You could use full body or upper body according to your need. Now use the Laura weight here, adjusting to whatever you want. Here are some examples.
And here the picture that I use.
Now to use it, we're going to make a prompt first. You could use any prompt to generate a woman, including her body. You could use full body or upper body according to your need. Now use the Laura weight here, adjusting to whatever you want. Here are some examples.
Be careful when using image with teeth. It could generate a talking teeth. You could also use a song, and the program will still recognize its voice. So it will make the picture sing a song.
Sleep though that you can get away with skeletons in your clothes, and though I think so, we don't reveal the truth up to the public. Put your hands up, don't surrender.
Also, when use full, if you don't want the image to make too strong movement that will make or show clipping on the neck, try to use still mode. Here is a comparison between two modes.
You look like sleep though that you can get away with skeletons in your clothes, and though I think so, we don't reveal the truth up to the public. Put your hands up, don't surrender. Make over, stop before we get out. Make over, stop, it's gonna fade away. When I climbed all that wind, it's hard to hit the ceiling with a black wall for being ice. So much.
Lastly, you could experiment with pose style. Pose style offer you 47 way of movement from 0 to 46. Just experiment with it and select that you like. Here are more examples.
Pinocchio is mostly used for you to simplify installing many AI module like Stable Diffusion, Automatic 1111, Forge, Stable Cascade, Magnet, AudioCraft, Comfy UI, Video Crafter, Stream Diffusion, and many more. To install this complex AI module, you simply just do one click on Pinocchio. After that installation will be finished, and you could start downloading and installing any AI program from Discover. Okay guys, since in the future I will mostly use Pinocchio to download and install AI program, I will stop the video here. The example of how to install AudioCraft plus 2 AI using Pinocchio will be shown on the next video.
Here are a few of pose style examples. 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 Anyway, guys, I think that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.